welcome to my studio. Today's picture is going to be a beach scene with a late evening storm coming in. Just a bit of a beach scene here with a couple of indications of some people in the background and a little bit of a boat just to break the ground up a bit. And some dunes and mostly sky. So I'm just going to be using six colours today. That's black, titanium white, yellow, china red, burnt umber, and phthalo blue. And I'll be using some extender as well. It just makes the acrylic paint flow better onto the canvas and also extends the life of the paint, or the usable life of the paint. So basically, I want a nice bright blue patch in the middle here with some nice white puffy clouds, then merging into grey stormy clouds and maybe some very, very dark grey stormy clouds in this area here and here. Okay, let's start painting. Okay, so we're going to get some of that beautiful blue colour. I'm going to put that just here. And we're going to get a big old dollop of white. You'll tend to use about three times as much white as any other colour. Just mix a little bit here. A bit darker. You can go darker and lighter. Nice little sky blue colour there. And we'll start applying it to our canvas. Okay, so we're going to come in here. Nice bit of blue there. This stage we're just blocking in with a bit of colour, a bit darker up here, just covering the canvas. Beautiful blue colours. Just wash it in there, like this. I want to keep an area here of white. Again, darker over here maybe. Coming down, sort of through here, like this. Just scrub it on. Maybe go a little bit lighter here. At this stage, what we're doing is getting colour onto our canvas and filling in the canvas. It doesn't matter, you can bring it down in over your sand dune area, that really doesn't matter. A bit lighter here. Wash it in. a little streaky. Like this. A little bit more really blue here. And possibly here. Wash it down towards the sea. So we've basically blocked in our sky. Maybe a little darker there. That's okay. So what I'm going to do now is I'm not going to clean my brush at all. I'm just going to get some white and some black just to make a grey colour. Actually, I might use a bit of a smaller brush. Just wash it up into the sky. A little better. Got a bit of light glare on there. It's difficult for me to actually see the shade of colour there, but I think that'll be about right. I've just had a look at that and I think it's a little bit too blue, so I'm going to put a bit of white in here and tone it down a little bit. I think that's a little better. Okay. That's a little better. I'm a little happier with that. So I'm just starting to put some grayer skies in. Sort of stormy clouds. More grey. I want this more sort of greyer here, I think. Going all the way up into this area. Like a grey blue rather than just bright blue. Just give it a little bit of interest like this. Now some real stormy clouds rolling in. Get the effect of rain coming down here. Could even probably go a bit darker. I think. Just here. A little bit happier with that, I think. Just want to lighten this up a little bit. So when you've got some, you've actually got some paint on your canvas, you can then start putting some more detail into it, or detailed colouring. Oh, that's a nice effect, I like that. Okay. And more grey over here. I don't like that patch of blue, I don't think. Maybe I'll leave just a little bit of it. That hint of blue up in that top corner, maybe. And more stormy clouds. And a bit more white here. Because I like this. So we're going to bring this down here. Because we're going to have a bit of a bank of cloud there as well. White cloud, that is. Yeah, quite like that. A little bit of atmosphere here too. Okay, I'll go with that, I think. So the next thing I'm going to do is get a big dollop of white, like that. Put it in the middle here. Dab it in there. I'll leave that to dry off for a little bit, I think. Bring that down here slightly. Okay, I'm going to dry that off a little bit with my hairdryer. And we'll come back and revisit this. Get some more of this white now, dry that off a little bit. just like to put a darker edge on the underside of the clay base there. The effect of the clay moving, as it were. Okay, so I just want to put a bit of, while this is drying up a little bit, I just want to put some beach color in here. So let me see, a little bit of burnt umber, some yellow. while I'm here, I just want to put a little bit of colour in on this boat. Just an indication of the bolt there. A bit darker up here, I think. It's a bit of an indication of the bolt there, I think. Okay, the next thing I want to do is get some blue, a little bit of blue and some black, a little bit of extender with that as well. Just get our water line in there. Maybe lighten that up a little. I want to flow into this paint as it's still wet, like this. So I put quite a bit on. Then what I'm going to do okay, so I'm just going to get a little tiny bit of water on my finger and line, you know, it sort of goes turquoisey and it's sort of with the water coming in and out, it sort of blends together with the sand like this, and your finger can actually be quite a useful tool for blending the paints together like that, and it gives you the effect of the water at the shoreline. It doesn't matter that it's streaky like this, because that's what it actually is like. So it sort of blends the color of the sand and the sea together, and you get the turquoisey type color, which is quite realistic for beaches. And this is a useful tool to have, is your finger. And this is just rough at the moment. And we'll do more detail as the painting progresses, but basically we've got a sort of background color on here. So now we're going to start to do some detail work, and we're going to start doing some detail up in the sky. Okay, so I'm just going to mix up a little bit of gray here, white and black, a lighter gray maybe. Let's try that. I'm going to come in here and I'm just going to put some gray here. Right in the middle, like this. Just there like that. And actually put some here as well, like this. What a bluey grey. So I'll just take a bit of this grey that I have. I just want to put some of this bluey grey in here. Maybe a bit lighter. That's better. I want some streaky cloud like this. It's quite nice actually to have this sort of an imperfection here. That might make that a little bit sort of blues and greys and a little bit of white mixed in as well. Maybe a I think this always sets the sky off. Just put a little tiny bit of hint of redness in the sky. Like this. A bit over here. I hope I'm not in the way there, but a few streaks of red through the sky. I want to try and keep that really, really blue there. And when this is dried a little, I just want to make some puffy cloud here. Maybe a little bit of streakiness of red up here. That, just a hint. Don't overpower it. I think that's enough. Maybe a little bit more there. Okay, I just want to put a bit of movement now in this water. Put some sort of indications of waves. So let's have some of that. That. Just the indication of sort of waves like this. Because waves come in sets. A little darker on that, I think. The sea has got a like a greeny, grey sort of look to it because it reflects, I suppose, the sky. It's not strictly all blue. I want to keep that dark line there, if I can. Only needs an indication of sort of waves, really. Maybe a little bit bluer than that. A little bit of white here. White foam. So I'd just like to tap the white in to represent the crest of the wave, and then just pull it down and away to give an indication of a falling wave like this. So just tap and pull. Of course, as it goes away from you, it gets less and less. And of course, as the wave stands up further, it's more vertical, like this. Just give the wave some shape. In the trough, this, real rough sea. Of course, as it gets farther away from you, it gets slightly darker. There you go, real rough sea. Okay. Quite a bit up the shore there, and here maybe, possibly. Still got a bit of a greeny tinge there, so you can sort of visualize seeing the sand underneath the waves as the water gets a little, sort of shallower. But yeah, that's okay, I think. Something like that. A little bit of white on the tip of here. Give the illusion of quite rough water here. Okay, so I've got a filbert brush now, and I'm just going to push in a bit of blue on there, haven't I? Which I don't want. Okay, let's try. Just modeling this white. pull down. a little bit more, so I'm put a little bit more grey here. Create some sort of streakiness here, as if there's quite a bit of airflow. Get that white there. That's what I want. And a little bit more grey on the top here. Right there. Underside of that cloud. So you can just, you know, add. I'm after a streaky effect of the grey going into the white, or actually reverse painting. So what I'm going to try and do now is clean this brush out and use a clean brush and drag some of that white into here. Still not quite happy with that. This is okay. really wanted to soften that grey. And pile this cloud up a bit more. I'd like to continue this way, actually. Alright, suppose I'd better paint something to anchor this boat. Put a little post in the ground here. Quite a big rope. There's a rope. That's better, I think. It looks as though there's two ropes. Okay, so thank you for joining me for this fairly simple little summer beach storm painting. If you have, please like and subscribe, and I hope you come and have a look at one of my other painting videos. And if you really like what I'm doing, you could consider becoming a patron to the channel. So thank you for joining me, and it's bye for now.